Three out of four is not bad. Balloon Fiesta is celebrating scenes just like this one tonight, hoping crowds will remember the three successful mass ascensions over the past 9 days, instead of focusing on today's farewell event, which was called off because of some bad weather. The big event ended with more of a fizzle than a bang. Crowds went home a little disappointed this morning, since the balloons couldn't even inflate in the high winds. We sent Action 7 News reporter Chris Ramirez to see how cancellation impacted Fiesta vendors' bottom lines.
When you set up shop here,
get the original breakfast burrito.
You have to hope for the best.
Hot chocolate.
And when it's bad, we cry. When it's good, we're happy as can be for a while.
And when vendors come to Balloon Fiesta, they know that they're taking a gamble, because if it's too windy, if it's too rainy, they know that the crowds just aren't going to come.
All morning events at Balloon Fiesta Park have been canceled.
Take last year, for example. Rain made for some miserable mornings, canceling three out of four mass ascensions. A cancellation today makes vendors a little nervous about their financial figures.
A lot of people have left. Our business is about half is what it normally would be.
Vendors say they are relying on three successful mass ascensions this year, plus two popular special-shaped Glodios Thursday and Friday to carry them through. Many traveled from other states and have travel costs they need to compensate for.
We come from Phoenix. It's our 12th year here, so it's very weather-dependent.
Small business owners know that New Mexico's weather can be tricky in October, and most prepare for that. Now, all report in comparison to Fiesta 2008, they're up in profits for 2009.
In the ice cream business, it affects us more than anybody else, so we're selling ice cream in October, so I'm happy.
Go out there and fly kite, okay?
Thank you very much.
Weather's perfect, thank you.
At Balloon Fiesta Park, Chris Ramirez, KOAT Action 7 News.
More details. The city estimates for every $1 spent producing Balloon Fiesta, another $17 is generated in the economy. In the last 2 weeks, the city believes about $97 million were spent by tourists and Fiesta visitors around the metro area and Santa Fe. And police certainly made their presence known at this year's Fiesta, and officers say crime dropped dramatically. The most serious report around the park was one auto burglary. Compare that to last year, when thieves struck visitors' vehicles all over the Duke City during Fiesta. APD credits heightened patrols and some new high-tech tools they used for the first time. And with another Balloon Fiesta in the books, one city councilor is looking at ways to make more of the park and the facilities around it. Action 7 News reporter Royal Day is live now at the park for us to explain the plan. Royal.
Well, Shelley, Albuquerque City Councilor Debbie O'Malley says there isn't one unified agency overseeing the park and museum, so she's hoping the city council will back her vision to redefine this area as a campus.
Balloon Fiesta 2009 brought tens of thousands to Balloon Fiesta Park and the Balloon Museum the past few weeks, but Councilor Debbie O'Malley says she has a plan that could make this area more successful, possibly year-round.
It needs to make more revenue, yeah, but I think it can do it effectively if everybody's working together.
O'Malley says right now Fiesta Park is run by Parks and Rec, the museum by Cultural Affairs. O'Malley says this creates confusion and nothing gets done.
We have separate interests. They're all on their own timetables. They have to worry about their own budgets, you know, that kind of thing.
O'Malley has introduced legislation that would create one board which oversees what she calls a Balloon Fiesta campus. Her vision combines the park and museum into one well-oiled machine.
So I think if we have a structure, an oversight group, where everybody has a stake in this, including the museum, then maybe we can get some of these things taken care of.
Now, her board, O'Malley says, would consist of balloonists, community members, and, of course, museum leaders. The counselor says right now there is only a volunteer board that makes suggestions, but it does not have the authority to make decisions. Reporting live, Royal Day, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The full city council will hear Councilor O'Malley's proposal next month.